The Israeli Supreme Court decided not to extend Omar Shakir's visa, a Human Rights Watch activist who openly called to boycott Israel, forcing him to leave the state of Israel within a few days. And the hypocrisy is mind-blowing. But let's be honest. We don't really need this video or any other explanation for this decision. Israel is a democratic sovereign state and as such is completely justified in deciding who will enter its borders and who will not, just like any other democratic country in the world. This American citizen was deported from the UK. So, in Ireland, for example, you're not allowed in if you're contrary to public policy. No problem. Yet the only democratic country in the world that is slandered for deporting someone who threatens its security is Israel. Let's dig in deeper for a moment. It would be reasonable to say that Israel attracts the largest presence of human rights organizations and activists per capita in the world. And according to the Israeli law, which guarantees free speech, these activists are allowed to lie, slander, and even demonize Israel, and that's okay. Well, it's not okay, but it's allowed legally. However, Israeli law forbids economic warfare against the state of Israel in the form of boycotts. Makes sense, right? Why should a country host a foreign citizen who calls for its boycotting and undermines its legitimacy? And that's precisely what Omar Shakir did.
I encourage you to all look to a campaign of boycotts, divestment, sanctions.
Omar Shakir is an activist of the anti-Semitic BDS movement who violated Israeli law by calling for Israel to be removed from the International Soccer Federation, FIFA, promoted a boycott of Israel by Airbnb, called for a boycott against Israeli banks, and more. Shakir tried to prove his innocence twice in Israeli courts and failed. There is no reason in the world for a country to host an individual who repeatedly violates its laws and jeopardizes its security. But once the court decided not to extend Shakir's visa, a well-orchestrated onslaught was waged against Israel, delegitimizing it and comparing it to North Korea. Even hypocrites like the EU called the Israeli government to reverse its decision while they continue to refuse visas to individuals whose entry could be contrary to public policy. So don't be mistaken. The present issue with Omar Shakir is a symptom of a much broader phenomenon of applying double standard to one country alone, Israel. Oh, by the way, Boomerang has been documenting the daily war crimes perpetrated against Jewish civilians by Palestinian Arabs in the form of violent terror attacks. We have proof of over 1,800 crimes from the beginning of 2019, and we welcome any international human rights organization to contact us and help us fight against human rights violations when turned against Jewish civilians. Thank you for watching. Please share this video and join Boomerang in its fight for truth.